children and old people, and the men go back to fight, and this will continue.
Roseanne, our time is up. I want to get back with you again. We'll schedule you in here in the next couple of weeks and continue this discussion because it's so interesting. Thank you.
Okay.
Roseanne, class director of the Afghan Information Center, a part of Freedom House in New York City, and she's also part of the Afghan Relief Committee. I want to talk to her about that next time. WLEA, Hornell, it's 9 o'clock.
From ABC News, I'm Doug Limerick. The Iran-Contra hearings have just resumed, and Attorney General Ed Meese is now on the hot seat. Here's ABC's Vic Ratner.
In the statement which he will read to the committees this morning, Attorney General Edwin Meese rejects any charges that he was involved in a cover-up during his fact-finding investigation of the Iran-Contra affair last November. Meese will tell the committees there was no hint that any criminal activity was in any way implicated in the Iranian arms transactions. And that, he will say, is why he did not call in the FBI or the Justice Department's criminal investigation during the period of time when he interviewed all the principal players in this investigation last fall. Vic Ratner, ABC News at the Iran-Contra hearings.
I'll have more news after this.
If you're concerned about heart disease and your doctor advises exercise, the right foods, and an aspirin a day, you should know that the brand of aspirin heart specialists recommend most is Ecotrin. Safety-coated Ecotrin, recommended more than 10 to 1 over Bayer. Heart specialists know the importance of aspirin. Studies with people who've had a heart attack or unstable angina show aspirin reduces heart attacks as much as 50%. So ask your doctor about Ecotrin. The one heart specialists recommend 10 to 1 over Bayer.
Beautiful landing, Bob.
Thanks.
What you've just heard was not an actual plane landing. It was a flight simulator at American Airlines Training Center. And the man at the controls is one of our pilots with over 20 years' experience. We believe in giving all our people extensive training and retraining so their skills stay their sharpest. This kind of dedication to excellence ensures American Airlines will always be something special in the air.
The Soviets have announced that the young West German who flew across the Soviet border and landed in Moscow's Red Square a while back will be put on trial next month. Matthias Rust has been in custody ever since he shocked the Soviets, making it all the way to Moscow in a small plane. The Iraqis have shot down a Syrian jet fighter that apparently flew over Iraqi territory. More from ABC's Ron Bagnulo.
The air corridor along the Syrian-Iraqi border is fraught with peril at the best of times, as is the relationship between the two Middle Eastern neighbors. There have been numerous incidents in the past involving military as well as civilian aircraft, the latest being a bomb explosion aboard an Iraqi 737 which crash-landed while on its way to Jordan. Though Syria has been a staunch supporter of Iran during the course of the seven-year-long Iraq-Iran war, moves have been afoot to bring Syria and Iraq closer together. Today's shooting down of the Syrian MiG-21 over Iraqi territory will not help that reconciliation process. Ron Bagnulo, ABC News, in the Gulf.
The reflagged tanker Bridgeton has undergone minor patching of that hole caused by a mine last week, and the Coast Guard now says the ship can take on some oil and can sail back down the Persian Gulf. The tanker's Navy escorts will be on the alert for mines during the return trip, which is slated for later this week. The chief doctor for the nation's largest Indian tribe says AIDS is quickly spreading through many tribes and could wipe out some smaller reservations, partly because the culture tolerates bisexual relationships. He says, as of last December, the Navajos did not have a reported case of AIDS. Now 39 cases have been reported. Temperature in Athens dropped to 100 today, down to 100. Highs had been 110 or even higher for the past 10 days. There, as many as 1,000 Greeks have died from the intense heat. Ham radio operators throughout the United States heard a Mayday call last night. It came from a boat in the Pacific, which radioed it was burning. 18 people reported on board the boat. Coast Guard sent a plane to investigate. The Coast Guard's anxious to find out what kind of survival suits five fishermen were wearing when their boat sank in 55-degree water off Alaska. The men were in the cold water all night long inside their waterproof suits. They're all right. A sixth fisherman could not get a suit on, and he died. Former First Lady Betty Ford reported to be in good condition after surgery at Med Center in California. She's 69. When the Pope comes to the U.S. in September, he'll be getting together with more than 30 Protestant and Orthodox leaders. And the U.S. Catholic Conference adds those leaders will not be from fundamentalist groups. This is ABC News.
It was horrifying because I was all alone in a place I hadn't been to before, and it was pretty tough.
A true story.
Well, I was vacationing, and then I went to Atlantic City. I had my wallet picked from my pocket. I lost over $730 or $40 in cash, but I just broke out in the sweat that was beyond belief, you know?
$700 sweat.
Exactly.
It could happen to you. So when you're on vacation, don't carry cash. Carry American Express traveler's checks. Don't leave home without them.
For the ABC Information Network, I'm Doug Limerick.
It's 9:05. The temperature is 67, going to 79. I'm Joy Gilmore with news from WLEA. The Steuben County Board of Elections has drawn slips of paper.